Hi, I'm Mary Kinloch, and today we're going to do a 1/12 scale gladiola flower. Okay, let me get this situated so you can see. The first thing that I did was I painted the sheet of flowers. This one I painted yellow, and a sheet of the green. They look like little leaves, but I use them for a calyx on this plant. Okay, on the flower, the first thing that you'll notice is that the first three rows are larger petals. They're the flowers that are going to go at the bottom. There's two side by side, and one is slightly larger than the other. So normally I don't take them out except for the two at a time so that I can keep them straight as to which one is larger and which one's smaller. It really won't matter if you get them mixed up, but it is better to have the smaller one on the inside and the larger one on the outside of the petals. Now, the next thing that I did was I took my 30 gauge wire and I just tipped it in a little bit of white glue. Now, what that does is it makes a little tiny ball on the end of your wire. And I'll show you why. So I'm going to put the wire that I've already got dried with the glue at the tip. I'm going to put it in the center where the hole is, turn and gently twist until it catches, like you're trying to catch a bead. Then I'm going to push it to the top. Now, you see that little dot of white glue that you put at the end of the wire? Keeps you from pushing the flower completely off of the wire. Okay, now I'm going to do the same thing with the second petal. And then I'm going to take a toothpick and touch a little bit of white glue under the first petal, and I'm going to push this one up to the top and try to make them alternate so that there you have the flower with a top three petals and a lower bottom three petals. Now, at this point, I would probably paint the center, if you want a center, like a pinkish center in this yellow flower, or you just have to look at some pictures of the real flowers and see how they contrast. Now, the tricky part of this is to shape this. This has been cut on the Japanese crepe cotton paper that is wonderful for shaping. And what I do is I put my tweezers in the center of the petal, push in and kind of out, because the flower petal flops over. Now, if I do that on all of them, push in, push in and pull out. This is moving a little bit because I didn't wait for it to dry, which is a very important thing to do. Okay, so we're gonna take the center of the petal, push in and out. Let me see if I can show you one that's a little better. This is a white one that I've pushed the petals in and out and over. Okay? Now, the other thing you need to do is kind of catch the edges of the flower petals with your tweezers and give a little twist. That makes the paper not look so flat. Okay? So there's the beginning of a flower. And as you see, I've put the calyx on the bottom. What I do with the green little leaf petals is hold them in the middle lengthwise with your tweezers, pinch them together, okay, then dip the lower end in the white glue. On this I only use white glue. So I need two of these. Fold it lengthwise. And opposite the other one. So that now you see you have a flower with a calyx under it. Okay, the next step is, and it's important that you use 24 gauge wire, a heavier wire than the 30 gauge that you were using for the flowers. Fold a lot of the little green leaves lengthwise like you did for the flower. The top of the flower stalk is what we're going to work on now. What I do is I just use white glue on this and put one facing the other. Okay? Okay, now when you get about this many, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you do this as much as you want the buds to be at the top. So if you look at this flower, it has a few little buds at the top and then the smaller flowers and then coming down to the larger and larger flowers. Okay, so let's see here. After we get this this flower stalk started and it's dry, it's time to put the flowers on. And this is probably the most difficult part in that you can make it pretty messy if you're not careful. So you puddle out your few drops of Zap-A-Gap. We've seen this before. We're going to start with a smaller flower and dip. I've cut the flowers off of the wire so that they're flush. So after you've made the flower like this, You're going to cut it off so that it's flush with the wire. And then you're going to dip one side of it lightly in white glue and very lightly in the Zappa Gap. And with it laying on the wax paper, you're going to set one beside. Okay, and then you're going to, I'm kind of holding this the wire down so that it doesn't move, and I'm trying to get the glue not to seep under. One of the things that I do is after I get, say, two flowers glued on, I'm going to as soon as I can, now that's too soon, but you see the one did stick, I pick it up. The reason that I pick it up is because if you let this sit, it is going to puddle in the back of the flower, and then you'll have a messy flower on the back, which won't be a problem if you're going to conceal it in up against a wall or something. But if it's in a flower arrangement in front of a mirror, then that's not good. Okay, now I keep working down. Put the next one . Okay, now this, I happen to grab a bigger flower. So normally I would do a couple of the smaller ones and then a couple of the bigger ones, so that I'm using about 7 flowers. Okay, now I'm going to see if I can pick it up, and I can't yet. So I sometimes just kind of have to touch the flowers. There we go. Make sure they're touching your wire, and by picking them up, it's not puddling up in the back. Then I move over and add maybe another flower, or, you know, my six more flowers. And I keep working down from one side to the other side until I'm happy with the length of the flower. Now, this one, I think I got a little bit too many buds at the top. But, you know, if you get to that point, you can always cut it off and then finish off that top with another leaf. In fact, let's do that. So that I can show you. Okay. So now I'm going to take another of my folded leaves and just using the white glue, I'm going to put it at the very top, kind of down so that it's opposite. Now, one thing that I would be doing is the buds. The real tiny buds, I use, it's a model railroad landscaping material. This is not like the Woodland Scenics foam. I'm not sure where I got it, but you just look around in the model train stores. It's kind of a heavier, crispy material that it really makes good buds. And in white, you can, if you get only white, then you can paint it. Okay, now I'm going to open these buds up a little bit and dip a little piece of it in white glue and stick it on this corner inside the kind of calyx. Sometimes you just take a little clump of it and pieces of it will fall away. And there you have little buds. Okay, let's say we've painted the inside with a contrasting color, like a pink or whatever, and that's dried. And the next thing we're going to do is, remember, if you've seen the other videos, I've taken silk embroidery floss, stiffened a single strand of it, then pick up one strand that's been stiffened, and I cut them in little pieces and dip them in white glue. You can use the Zappa Gap on this if you like, and just do like five little stamens in each flower. Now don't worry about at this point the length of them, because you can always trim them. So I just get all the stamens in place. Okay, now they look long and hideous, but I'm going to take our little scissors. And after I let this dry and I have these little pieces of thread in all of the flowers, then I trim them. Okay. Now, one time years ago, I did this as a class, and what I do next is I have a little container of gel medium mixed with white paint, and if it gets too thick, keep a little bottle of distilled water on your table. The reason I say distilled, in Florida, things start growing green stuff if you put tap water. So here the gel medium is fairly thick, and what I do with it is take it on the toothpick, and I just touch the tips of those threads. I remember that class going, wow, it brought them to life. And it does. That one little detail brings your flower so to life. You can't see it that well on the red one. I mean, on the white one. But on the red one, you can really see how that touching these just brought them to life. Okay, now, this I've put the little red pieces of the model train landscaping material in the very top here. Then I've taken some of the paper, my favorite paper, which is the Japanese crepe, and hand cut it, the side leaves. Okay, here's a piece of the Japanese paper that I have painted, and it's real easy to hand cut these kind of leaves because they're just little spikes. And I have the grain going up and down. I'm going to cut this point off to make it look a little more rounded and even up the side. This particular piece of paper, I think I sprayed one side of it with a gloss so that it's a little bit shiny. Sometimes I do that and it kind of adds a little bit of realism. Now, here's one of the things that I can tell you I love about this paper. I usually, for the gladiola, it tends to be a straight sword-like leaf. But if you strip it like you're stripping wire, you get a little curve to it. And I pinch the bottom edge together, and then with just white glue, I put it on the stock with the leaf sort of going behind it a little bit. Okay? Then I do one on the other side until you get and two of them. So I've done two here. Check the back. Make sure the back doesn't look yucky. And if it does, touch up with some paint over those glue spots so that if someone looks at the back of your flower, they won't see yuck. Okay? And here again, this paper that all the flowers and everything are cut on is Japanese crepe. On my flower making group on Facebook, the place where I get the paper connection, is on there. And the lady that helps us is very nice. Anyway, I love playing with this paper. You can see how you strip it like you're stripping ribbon. You can twist it, and it stays, pretty much stays put. So you can twist it, do all kinds of things. Okay, I think that's about it for gladiolas. If you have any questions, find me on Facebook, on my flower making group called Making Dolls House Flowers in All Scales. Thank you.